hydrostatic forces on immersed surfaces. The case 1, the first case would be hydrostatic thrust or force on a horizontal lamina. I have taken a liquid of density is rho. I had considered a lamina. What do you mean by lamina? A plane surface of negligible thickness, maybe regular or irregular shaped lamina of area A. Let A is equal to area of lamina, W is equal to specific weight of liquid, which would be equal to the rho g, kilonewton per meter cube. Since earlier we have known that all the points in a liquid, static mass of liquid, at the same level are subjected to same hydrostatic pressure, and because the lamina is kept in a horizontal position, because all the points of the lamina are at the same depth below the surface, free surface, this is the free surface, it is denoted with a inverted triangle symbol. Free surface means the surface exposed to the atmosphere, the surface of the liquid exposed to the atmosphere is known as free surface. Now we could indicate the hydrostatic pressure distribution on the lamina like this. All the points of the lamina, because they are at the same depth below the free surface, all of them are subjected to the same hydrostatic pressure. Since all the points or all the locations, I can say even rather, all the locations of the lamina are at the same depth below the free surface, all of them are subjected to same hydrostatic pressure. So this is a pressure variation. I can say this is pressure exerted over the lamina. So the hydrostatic force on the lamina is equal to pressure into area of lamina. What is the pressure? Pressure P is equal to W X bar. What is that X bar? X bar is the depth of the center of gravity of the lamina below the free surface, where X bar is equal to depth of centroid or CG of lamina below free surface. Therefore, hydrostatic thrust on lamina is equal to W x bar into area of the lamina. So this is pressure. Pressure P is W x bar kilonewton per meter square. So many kilonewtons. So this is W A x bar kilonewtons. This hydrostatic force is also known as total pressure. Indicated with capital P. Please note that total pressure is not the pressure, it is actually the force. W is the specific weight, A is the area of the lamina, and X bar is depth of centroid or center of gravity of the lamina below the free surface. This is X bar. Therefore, P is equal to W A X bar kilonewtons. Now I shall define center of pressure is the location where total pressure acts on the lamina. So the point of application of the total pressure, that is the hydrostatic force acting on the lamina, is known as center of pressure. Since all the points are subjected to same hydrostatic pressure, in the case of horizontal lamina, the total pressure P acts at centroid or center of gravity of lamina. Let H bar is equal to depth of CP, that is center of pressure below free surface. Therefore, for all horizontal laminae, H bar is equal to X bar, that is CP and CG coincide. For all horizontal laminae, center of pressure and center of gravity coincide. That is, the hydrostatic thrust acts at the centroid of the lamina. That is, hydrostatic thrust acts at CG or centroid of lamina. Now I shall consider case 2. Hydrostatic force on vertical lamina may be regular or irregular shaped. I shall consider a liquid of density rho and irregularly shaped lamina. What do you mean by lamina? A surface whose thickness is negligible. I considered a lamina of irregular shape kept in the vertical position in a liquid of density rho. This is the free surface of liquid. Now it is required to calculate what is the hydrostatic thrust or total pressure exerted over the lamina, and also to know the point of application of this total pressure on the lamina, that is to calculate depth of center of pressure, that is the point of application of total pressure on the lamina. So that is the objective of this particular topic. Let A is equal to area of lamina. Consider a horizontal strip of thickness dx and width b lying at a vertical depth x below the free surface of liquid. As shown in figure, that is, this is the strip of width b and depth is dx, this is dx. What is the depth of that strip below the free surface? That is x. This is the strip. Since the thickness of the strip is being very small, the pressure intensity exerted by the liquid on the strip is assumed to be constant. Let P is equal to Wx is the pressure intensity exerted by liquid on this strip. Since dx being very small, the pressure intensity is assumed to be same everywhere on this strip. The area of strip is b into dx. Therefore, total pressure on this strip, elemental strip, is equal to dp is equal to pressure intensity into area. What is the pressure intensity? W into x. What is the area of the strip? B dx. So this is the differential total pressure exerted over that small differential strip dp. Hence the total pressure acting on the vertical lamina is equal to integral dp, that is, can be denoted as capital P, that is integral wx bdx. What is that w, which is a constant specific weight? Therefore capital P is equal to w integral x bdx. What is x bdx? But integral x bdx is nothing but sum of all the first moments of the areas of the strips about an axis OO. What is it OO? It is the axis which is obtained by intersection of the free surface of the liquid with the vertical plane in which the plane surface is lying. That is, if you imagine that the plane surface, vertical plane surface is extended up to the free liquid surface, the axis obtained is known as OO. Therefore, this is equal to product of area A and distance x bar of the centroid of the surface area from the same axis OO. Implies capital P is equal to W A X bar. What is that X bar? X bar is depth of the center of gravity or centroid of the lamina below the free surface. So, for horizontal lamina and as well as for the vertical lamina, the total pressure P is calculated as a product of three things: specific weight of the liquid, area of the lamina, and the depth of the centroid of the liquid. Centroid of the area. X bar is the centroid of the area of lamina below the free surface. X bar is depth of centroid or center of gravity of the lamina below the free surface. Now, our objective is to get where this point of application of total pressure lie, which is also known as center of pressure. That means, where does the center of pressure act? Where does the center of pressure of the lamina lie? Let H bar is equal to depth of center of pressure of lamina below free surface. For vertical lamina, H bar is equal to X bar plus IG by AX bar. What is that IG? Where IG is equal to area moment of inertia of lamina about axis passing through centroid and parallel to axis OO lying in the free surface. A is the area of the lamina. X bar is depth of centroid of the lamina below the free surface. For example, if the lamina is circular in shape, this is GG, whereas this is the free surface. This is X bar, depth of the centroid of the lamina below the free surface, and OO is lying in the free surface. Then IGG is equal to pi d to the power of 4 divided by 64. so many meter to the power of 4. This is the area moment of inertia of the circular lamina about an axis passing through its centroid GG, but lying parallel to the axis OO. If the vertical lamina is of triangular shaped, like this, this is B is the width of the triangular lamina, H is the height of the lamina, this is X bar, depth of the centroid of the triangle, this is free surface OO, this is area of the lamina is equal to half BH. IG is the moment of inertia of the lamina about the axis GG passing through the centroid but lying parallel to the axis in the free surface OO. This is BH cube by 36. How do we calculate the X bar? X bar is equal to, say this is Y. Y plus 2/3 H. What is that Y? Depth of the apex of the lamina below the free surface. This is the depth of CG below free surface. If the vertical lamina is of rectangular shaped as shown, like this, this is the width, this is the depth. So this is the center of gravity G. Let it be Y. Depth of the lamina, top of top edge of the lamina below the free surface. Free surface axis is OO. This axis is GG. Center of gravity, axis passing through the center of gravity but lying parallel to the OO. Then area is obviously width into depth, and IG is equal to BD cube by 12, and X bar is equal to depth of CG below free surface is equal to Y plus D by 2. From which the depth of the center of pressure could always be calculated. H, for in all the above cases, X bar is H bar, depth of the center of gravity below the free surface is X bar plus IG by AX bar. Please note that in all vertical lamina cases, center of pressure CP, that is the point where the total pressure acts, that is the point where the hydrostatic thrust exerted by the liquid on the lamina acts. Center of pressure CP always lie below center of gravity. In all the vertical lamina cases, center of pressure CP always lie below center of gravity, whereas for all the horizontal lamina cases, center of pressure and center of gravity both coincides. Now the case 3, I can say hydrostatic thrust or hydrostatic force on inclined lamina having calculated for the horizontal lamina and for the vertical lamina of any shape. Now we shall switch on to hydrostatic force acting on inclined lamina. This is the case 3, I can say. If this is the free surface means the surface of the liquid in contact with surrounding atmospheric air. This is the inclined lamina whose true shape of the lamina can be visualized like this. It may be of any shape. From the, if you see from the below, this is the eye of our view. If you see from the bottom, you will see the true shape of the lamina like this. So this is the center of gravity of the lamina. The angle of inclination of the lamina with the free surface is theta. This is the depth of center of gravity below the free surface is x bar. A is the area of lamina. X bar is depth of CG of lamina below the free surface. Theta is equal to angle of inclination of lamina with the free surface of liquid.